morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. Still 57?
Yes.
You're doing it.
Mind over matter. Mind over matter. Accept it.
Feels good. Cut down the 80 costs.
We will get them here and have hope warm for Christmas Eve. So they were just here Friday. So, but not working on this furnace, working on the office area, which isn't working either. So, so good morning.
Good morning.
It's great to be together on this fourth Sunday of Advent. We pray, blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Kingdom now and forever.
Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son, Jesus Christ, at his coming, may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
First reading is with Micah chapter 5 verses 2 through 5a. You, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from the old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be one of the peace. The Psalms, I don't know what, it's in your flyer. Psalm 8. And we'll repeat by verse. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, leading Joseph like a flock, shine forth you that are enthroned upon the cherubim.
In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh.
Stir up your strength and come to help us.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angry despite the prayer of your people?
You have fed them with the bread of tears. You have given them bowls of tears to drink.
You have made us with the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies brought to scorn us.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The second reading is Hebrews chapter 10, verses 5 through 10. When Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifices and offerings you have not desired, but a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sin offerings you have taken no pleasure. Then I said, see, God, I have come to do your will, O God. In the scroll of the book it is written of me, when he said above, you have neither desired nor taken pleasure in sacrifices and offerings, offering and sin offerings. Then he added, "See, I have come to do your will." He abolishes the first in order to establish the second. And it is by God's will that we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ for all. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is on those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Christ.
Almighty God, we have heard your word proclaimed here in our midst. May your word shape and form us into the people you have called us to become. Come on. You know, this past week, I had occasion to attend a Zoom conference. It was called by the West Virginia Council of Churches, and it addressed the topic of COVID. And really, the focus of the conference was on the state of affairs and what churches can do. That's not what I want to talk to you about. You've heard enough about that. But it got me to thinking, this time last year, we were not able to even be in church, you know? And this time last year, there were a lot of things that we couldn't do. mean, a lot of us were shut down. We couldn't even go visit each other. And certainly this season of Advent and the next week, the season of Christmas is a time when we spend a lot of time visiting. And it got me to thinking about visitors. You know, who are the people that we visit with? Because, you know, some visitors, you're really glad and happy when they arrive. There are other visitors you're really glad when they leave, you know? Some visitors come to bring you things. Some visitors come to see what they can get. Some visitors are wonderful. Some visitors make you wonder. Some are welcome, and others, well, you get the point. Visitors come in all shapes and sizes, and why that, I think, is critically important for us today is this gospel that we just heard is the gospel of the visitation. Mary goes to visit Elizabeth. Now, it's important for us to get in our head that back in Jesus' day, certainly the day when Mary went to visit Elizabeth, visits were more than just casual encounters. It wasn't like just bumping into somebody on the street. Visits had a deeper meaning. For instance, visits were intentional. To visit someone was for you to share a part of yourself with them and for them to share a part of themselves with you. Visits included having a common bond between those who visit. And certainly that's true in today's gospel, isn't it? I mean, Mary is intentional about what she's doing. It says she traveled for 4 days, pregnant and a teenager to get there. And she goes for this visit because she and Elizabeth share a common bond. In fact, they share a common bond in a number of ways. One way is they have both been visited by an angel named Gabriel, who has intervened in their lives to bring about really miraculous pregnancies. Another common bond that they share is they're both confused about this intervention. Elizabeth is confused because she has long ago given up on the possibility of childbirth. Mary is confused because even though she's already betrothed to Joseph, they're not married yet. So you have these two Middle Eastern women who are really low down on the social status ladder, who are singled out by God to transform the world by the birth of John the Baptist and the birth of Jesus. And we can only imagine what they might have talked about. Maybe they talked about what it was like to be visited by an angel. Maybe they talked about their confusion and their fear. Maybe they talked about their swollen ankles and their water retention and their morning sickness. We don't know, but whatever it was that they talked about in that visit, the visitation between Elizabeth and Mary shaped them and formed them, and that visit gave them the courage to move forward. Bear sons who would change the
the world for him.
And I think that we have something in common with them because we come here together today for a visitation. We come here to St. Paul's Church. We are intentional about being here. We made a decision to come here. There's more dozen, lots of other things we could be doing, but we decided to be intentional and come here. We certainly have a lot of things in common. And one of the things that we have in common is we share a belief that we have been visited by the presence of Jesus, who is God taking flesh in our world. There's lots of things we could talk about. We could talk about how cold we've been doing. We could talk about maybe how confused or afraid we are. We could talk about the darkness, the coldness, the worries of our world. We could talk about how we too are pregnant with hope as we anticipate and look forward to the celebration of Christmas. Whatever it is that we choose to talk about with one another this morning, we're united. We've made a decision to stand with one another, to offer support to one another in the midst of our fears, in the midst of our disappointments, in the midst of our confusion. And this visitation that we shared this morning will change us, hopefully, and give us the courage to go forth and bear God's Son to the world.
Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge both the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he has worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. We pray for our diocese in West Virginia, Trinity Shepherdstown, our companion diocese in Columbia, Mission Episcopal Jesu Cristo, Luz del Mundo, for the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for Justin Welby, our Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Mikey, our Bishop of West Virginia, and John, our rector. We pray for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one, as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, especially all elected public officials, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for our prayer list, Liz Aprazino, Donnie Wingler, Minter Ralston, Karen Ralston, Sarah Sturgill, Barty, Aunt Rosie, Shirley and Jill Stewart, Jerry Collins, Lisa Giles Alford, Martha Pickens, Jill Walser. For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for those serving in the military, Major Josh Wilson, Staff Sergeant Michael Ireland, Sergeant Paul Bryan, Sergeant E.J. Parks, Specialist Chris Dotson, Lieutenant John Robert Sturgill, Lieutenant Matthew Michael Smith, and Sergeant Tyler Smith. We pray for our vestry members and their families, Chris Heater, Carol Westfall, Tracy Weber, Janice Wolfter, Jill Stewart, Steve Wilson, Carla Carruthers, and Jim Smith. We pray for those celebrating birthdays this week, Chris Orchard and Janet Wolfter, and for those celebrating wedding anniversaries, Father John and Bertha Valentine. For this congregation, for those who are present, for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord,
have mercy.
For all who have died, especially Linda Probst and Jay Depew, in the communion of your church and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of the Virgin Mary and St. Paul and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and to one another and all our life to Christ our God.
For yours is the majesty, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin against God and neighbor.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may enjoy your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
consider yourself to be virtually cuffed. So, a couple announcements. We're going to greet the church after church today, so hopefully you can stay and help with that. And all of us pitching in together, it makes it go so much smoother and quicker. So thank you in advance for your help. Christmas Eve service here at St. Paul's, 9 o'clock. We will continue to wear masks, be socially distant, and be in church this year as opposed to last year. So, gosh, we're really excited about that. I mentioned before that Matthew Calvin will be consecrated as our new bishop on March the 12th in Buchanan. They are looking for volunteers to help with that service, so if you would like to volunteer to help, there's a link in the bulletin. It's longer than I can read and longer than you would probably remember, but it's in the bulletin. And his first official act is going to be to come here at St. Paul's. So his first visitation will be to St. Paul's Weston. So it's a great time if you know of people that might be baptized or received into the church or confirmed to make that happen. So let me know. We can certainly get that set up and make that happen. Finally, we're all aware of those affected by the weather and the tornadoes, especially in Kentucky, but throughout the Midwest. And I know it's been a tough year financially for all of us and for St. Paul. But in an effort to reach out to those who really have it a lot worse than we do, we're going to take up a collection on January 16th. That'll get us through the Christmas season, give us time to think about it. And that collection will go directly to the diocese, who will pass it directly to the Diocese of Kentucky, that we use it for direct aid. And the reason I mention that is that none of it goes to overhead or anything like that. It will go directly to help people who have been screened and who are in need. So that's January 16th. Anything else? We'll get the heat fixed. Thank you for being here and making this Eucharist possible. Walk in love as Christ loved us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
It's a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your blessed Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs to everlasting life. And when he shall come again in power and great triumph and judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, and your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, the Lord made flesh Jesus your Son. For in his last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. And on the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples. He said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took a cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and he said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant which is shed for you and for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death.
We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in this sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to the heavenly country. For St. Paul, the
body of Christ above.
Don't forget.